Does mental illness and gun violence actually have a scientific connection? After every major mass shooting in the US, there's always a discussion about whether or not the perpetrator's mental health was to blame. A recent study even showed that news media pairs mental illness with violence at a higher rate than it actually occurs. Oh, and then there's this.
I think that mental health is your problem here. This was a very, based on preliminary reports, very deranged individual.
Now, yeah, the shooter he's talking about did have a history of mental illness, but there is still a lack of scientific evidence to support the idea that America's gun problem is rooted in mental health. In fact, there's actually data that shows the opposite is true. Several epidemiological studies have shown that there is little to no correlation between mental illness and violence towards others. This includes people who suffer from schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, and severe depression. The National Institute of Mental Health carried out one of the first studies on the subject in 1990. They collected data from over 10,000 people across three major US cities. The study accounted for things like socioeconomic status and substance abuse problems. The ultimate conclusion was that if we were to somehow eliminate the risk of people with mental illness carrying out violent crimes, the amount of violent crimes in the US would only drop by about, 4%. A few years later, the MacArthur Violence Risk Assessment Study followed more than 1,000 psychiatric patients who had been discharged from medical care. The study discovered that patients who suffered only from a serious mental illness and had no substance abuse problems had the same risk in committing violent behavior as anyone else in their communities. And according to more recent national data from the US Department of Health and Human Services, only 3-5% of violent acts can be attributed to people who have serious mental illnesses. Now, the rate of violent crimes for this population does go up when you mix in substance abuse, but that's true for the general population as well. On the flip side of all this, people who suffer from serious mental illnesses are 10 times more likely to be the victims of violent crimes than members of the general population. They're also often the victims of self-inflicted violence. Over half of the gun fatalities in the US are from suicide. Experts believe that an emphasis on suicide would be a better policy approach in preventing gun violence, for which there is plenty of evidence and data, as opposed to focusing on mental illness's connection to mass murders, for which there is very little data. Lastly, finding a scientific connection between gun violence and, anything can be a difficult thing nowadays. That's because there was legislation passed in the late 1990s that essentially pulled funding away from any federal agency looking to study gun violence as a public health issue. I mean, the CDC gets funding to study rare diseases like cholera, diphtheria, polio, and rabies. Over the last 40 years, those diseases have only killed around 2,000 people in the US. In that same time frame, 1.4 million Americans have died because of firearms. So let's remember that, even when we see headlines that look like this. So if science can't solve the gun problem, what can it do? Lots, actually. Like, how about cleaning the air with bicycles? Find out about it here. Don't forget to subscribe and be sure to keep coming back to Seeker for more videos.